Hello, my name is Nan.
Social robots, their primary function is for social interaction with human beings. Although it has a lot of different functions, but its primary goal is to facilitate communication with human beings. And it's been applied in a lot of different areas, including education, family communication, health communication. For example, it has been applied to treat autistic children, helping them focus attention on learning or helps them express emotions. It has also been applied in K-12 education to teach STEM classes because kids will be more curious and more motivated to learn stuff from social robots. Hi, Nao.
Hi.
Good morning.
Oh, it's still the morning. Good morning, then.
What day is it today?
Today is Friday, October the 15th.
So this social robots is involves a lot of artificial intelligence techniques. For example, it has visual recognition, it has facial recognition, it also has voice recognition. So it helps a lot when social robots can actually see human beings talking to themselves, just like how we may feel comfortable facing other human beings when we do interpersonal communication. So my human-machine communication course basically covers all the aspects related to the process of human-machine communication. We focus on humans part, including user experiences, including user psychology. We also focus on machine part, which involves a lot about the role of machines, like how we perceive machines as if they were social actors in the society, and also how a machine has a relationship with the government, with the designers, with the engineers, with the developers. And we also kind of look at the whole social implications of human-machine communication. For example, we focus on a lot of topics such as technology determinism and social determinism, social constructivism, and all these kind of theories that may potentially help us understand the process of human-machine communication.